Assalamu alaikum, my dearest kids, and welcome back again with the virtual class which is being organized by your school, Metropolitan. I am your teacher, Miss Arisha, and I am today welcoming you back to this virtual class in which we are going to start with unit number 9, which is fantasy words. Now, let me tell you first what is a fantasy. Fantasy is called something which you are imagining just in your mind, which is not real, which is not linked with the reality. And words means the thing in which we are living right now, which is our world, the earth, right? So here we are talking about the imaginary world which we have in our mind. So let's start with the reading. So students, come on, grab up your books and open page number 52 because I am going to start the reading today. Unit number 9, lesson 3, Noor's new sword. Noor had a new plastic sword. It was silver colored with a flashing red drill in the handle and it came in a beautiful golden case. He fought the cat with his sword, he fought the pillow with his sword, he fought the mango trees in the garden. He even fought his sister's teddy bear. Then in the next paragraph, it's written that, "You are very naughty, Noor," said his mother sharply. "You must not frighten the cat and hit the trees. You must not burst the pillows and hurt your sister's teddy. Now say sorry to your sister." "Yeah," he shouted, because he was holding a sword, right? "No, dinner's for you, Noor," snapped his father. "Go up to your room." Noor stamped up the stairs angrily and banged the door behind him. He lay down in his bed and cried loudly. Knock, 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 he looked up. There at the window was a great black eagle with a sharp beak, enormous claws and fierce yellow eyes. Noor stopped crying and opened the window. He climbed on the bird's back and away they flew over the clouds, over the sea to a land far away. They landed in a wild country with snowy mountains and rushing rivers. Noor jumped off the eagle's back and turned round quickly. Behind him was a great wild forest. And out of the great wild forest came thirsty wild monsters with curly furs. They snapped their sharp teeth and they stamped their heavy feet. Slowly they walked towards him. Noor did not run away. He waved his sword and looked angrily at the monsters. "Stop!" he shouted. And the monster all stood still. You must give me food," Noor shouted. The monster went into the forest and brought him sweet mangoes and melons. "You must sing to me," yelled Noor. The monsters opened their enormous red mouths and sang. Noor decided to stay in the wild country with snowy mountains and rushing rivers. He went fishing with the monster. He went hunting with the monsters. He lived in their country for a long, long time. One day, he happened to look at the flashing red gel in the handle of his sword. He remembered the mango tree in his garden and his nice quiet cat. "I am going home," he said. "You can't go home," said the monster. "You must stay here with us and be our king. We'll bring you food, we'll sing for you, we'll take you fishing and hunting. You must not go away." But Noor said, "No, I must go home." The thirsty monster with curly fur snapped their sharp teeth and stamped their heavy feet. They flashed their green eyes and waved their spiky tails, but Noor climbed on the back of the great black eagle and away it flew, over the clouds and over the seas, back to the window of his room. In his room, on his pillow, he found a note from his mother. "When you say sorry, you can come and have your dinner," it said. Noor said sorry nicely and ate his dinner. It was lovely. This was the end of the story, guys. And in this story, here we are talking about a boy named Noor. He got a plastic sword as a gift from his family. But after getting the sword, he started to behave very badly with the things in his house and the things which was his sister's, right? After that, his father punished him by saying that go to your room and stay there. You will not have dinner at that night, right? Then after some time, when he was there, he suddenly had that fantasy in his mind that he went to a place which was consisting of monsters, right? And after that, he then went there and lived with the monster for a very long time. But after some time, he started missing all the things from his home. Then he told the monster that he wants to go back to his home, but the monster did not want him to go, right? So they tried to stop him, but he went away with the eagle in which he was flying. This was the whole fantasy of Noor's mind. Now, my dear students, we are going to start with the exercise of this chapter, which is on page number 53, and the exercise is exercise B on page number 53. As we have read the chapter, dear students, now we are going to circle the words which are in the box, and I'm going to write the right answer which you have to circle in your book, okay? So keep the pencils in your hand. I'm going to circle the first one, which is already done in your book. It is, Noor had a gun, sword or stick. What was he having? He was having a sword. You have to circle the word sword. After that, the second one is, he dashed things with his sword. So his father sent him to his what? He was hitting the things. So the first blank will be hit, and in the second box you have to circle room, because his father sent Noor to his room, right? Fourth one, the room, you have to circle the room in the third box. Then the fourth one is, then a boy bird or cat came. Then a bird came. Eagle is a bird, right? Then an eagle came. So we will circle bird. To the window and took him to a country with lots of what? With lots of monsters, pillows or houses. There were lots of monsters. So we are going to circle monsters. After that, the monsters helped hurt or hit him. Helped him. And gave him fruits, vegetables or meats. They gave him fruits. Because mango is a fruit, right? After some time, Noor went home and said good, sorry or fine for being naughty. He said sorry for being naughty with the things, and he said sorry to the family, right? Students, after completing the work of text, now let's start the grammar work. So in grammar, we are going to start with adverb. And adverb, my dear students, are those words which modifies, which gives another meaning, which tells you that details about the word. An adjective or any other adverb, like if I am speaking right now, how am I speaking? I am speaking loudly. So here the word loudly is defining my action that verbs are the action verbs, right? It is defining my action that I am speaking loudly. So the definition of verb is that adverbs are those words which gives another meaning, which gives the meaning, actually defines what the verb is telling, how it is, and it modifies the verb, adjectives, or the group of words. So let's start with the translation of few sentences. Here the first one is Ali tez bhagta hai. So let's start with the first subject. Ali, here is the subject Ali. What is the action word over here? Run. Ali runs. Kaise bhagta hai Ali? He runs fastly. So he runs fast. Ali tez bhagta hai. Ali runs fast. Here this fast is modifying the verb of Ali, the action of Ali which he is doing. He is telling that he is not running slowly, he is running fastly. Second one is wo achha gana gaati hai. She, what is the action word over here? What is the verb? Sings nicely. Okay students, now we are going to start number 3. It is Boodha aadmi aahista chalta hai. First the subject, which is old man. What is he doing? Walks slowly. Here the word slowly is describing how the old man is walking, right? Then the fourth one is Ustad narmi se baat karta hai. Teacher talks politely. Here this word which is politely is describing how the teacher talks. And the last one is wo zor se bolte hain. Here we are talking about the plural, so the word will not contain s. They speak, because we are talking about the plurals. They speak loudly. Okay students, now we are about to do the last part of our lesson, which is the oral of general knowledge. So the very first question is, how many siparas are there in Holy Quran? There are 30 siparas, right? So answer will be, there are 30 siparas in Holy Quran. Second one is, how many surahs are there in Holy Quran? And there are 114 surahs in our Holy Quran. Last question is, which surah is called the heart of Holy Quran? And the answer is Surah Yasin, my dear students. Surah Yasin is called the heart of Holy Quran. So let's do a short recap of what we have done in this lesson. First, we just read unit number 9, which was about fantasy world. After that, we did an exercise of that unit. After that, we did the work of grammar of adverb and the translation related to adverbs. And in the last, we did the oral work of general knowledge. So that's all for today's lesson. Hope to see you in the next one. Allah Hafiz.